Hello friends, today we are going to do insolvency of a partner problem. So this is a 10th question which we are going to do now. So with the help of this problem, we are going to try to solve the insolvency of a partner. So in this problem, there are three partners are there, A, B and C, and the profit sharing ratio is 4:3:2. Some information they gave related to the liabilities, assets and some adjustments they gave. So this we are going to discuss while doing the problem. So for doing the insolvency of a partner, we prepare the first account is realization account. So first account which we are going to prepare when we do the insolvency of partner is realization account. So this is in format debit, credit. On debit side we'll write it as a particular amount and credit side particular amount. So on debit side, the first entry which we are writing as a two sundry assets. Okay, so in the question, asset side, whatever the items are given, that the same items you will be writing to the debit side as a two sundry assets except cash. Okay, in question, whatever the items they gave on the asset side, that all items we going to write it on the debit side except cash. Okay, so the first entry is debtors, that is 1000, then stock 2000, then land and building 5500. So if we add all this amount, we'll get 8500. Now the same thing, credit side will write it as a buy liabilities. So in the balance sheet, current liabilities will take. So in this problem, they gave only one liabilities, that is creditors. So we'll write it as a creditors directly 3500. Now after that, they gave some adjustments. So whatever the assets realized or liabilities realized are there, we'll write it on the realization account opposite direction. Okay. So these assets, balance sheet assets, we posted on the debit side, but adjustments assets will write it on their credit side. Buy. We'll see. So in this problem, they are saying that A agreed to take over the stock at the valuation of 1500 and debtors at the valuation of 700. So here what is happening? Stock as well as debtors. These both are the assets. So but this stock debtors has been taken by the partner, that is a partner. So we'll write it as a buy A's capital, that is stock in brackets, we'll write stock and debtors. So stock amount is 1500 plus debtors is 700. If we add, we'll get 2200. Now after that, they are saying that the land and building are sold at an auction of 2700. So land and building is also an asset, but we'll write it as a buy bank. Buy bank in brackets land and building, how much? 2700. Then with that over, so these are the adjustments they said. Then to bank in brackets creditors, whatever the balance sheet credit amount is given, that the same amount will write it on the debit side also as a bank. So in realization account, the two steps you need to remember. The first point is balance sheet, whatever the assets are there, that you will be going to post it on the debit side except cash. Then liability side, whatever the liabilities are given, that you will be going to write it on the credit side. Then adjustment, assets and liabilities, you will be writing on the opposite direction. Suppose in adjustments they gave land and building. Okay, so this is an asset, but as I told you, opposite direction. So previously we wrote it on the debit side, now you will be going to write it on the credit side. Okay, but what you will be writing by bank, whatever the amounts are realized, that you will be writing as a bank. If at all they are not mentioning any partner's name, if at all they are mentioning the partner's name, so we'll write it as a partner's name. okay. After that, we are getting debit side is more. So with the total, we got 12,000. Okay. So we got by realization loss, that is 3,600. So this 3,600 we are going to distribute to their partners. So for partner A, 3,600. What is the ratio? 4:3:2. So it means 9. So 3,600 into 4/9. So we'll get 1,600. Then for partner B, 3,600 into 3/9. We'll get 1,200. And for C, 3,600 into 2/9. We'll get 800. Okay, so this is the form, this is the way, with the help of this, we need to do the realization account. After preparing the realization account, next account we prepare is partners capital account. Okay, so under the partners capital, how many partners are there? So that many we going to draw the columns. So first we'll write it on the credit side. It start by balance brought down. By balance brought down. So this is nothing but the opening balance of their capital. So for partner A, the capital amount is 4,000. Then for partner B, the capital amount is 2,000. And for partner C, the capital amount is 500. Okay. So this is the first entry which we write it on the capital account, on the credit side. After that, we need to check realization account. Do we finding any capital name? Okay, so debit side, do we finding any capital? No. But on credit side, we are finding as a by A's capital. Yes. So it is on which credit side? It is on a credit side. So when we prepare the capital account, we'll write it on the debit side. To realization, because we have taken from the realization account. So to realization account. So this is the partner A. So in the partner A, we'll write it as a 2,200. Okay. Then after that, we got the loss. Yes. So loss, it is on the credit side. So we'll write it on the debit side as a 2. Realization loss for partner A is a 1,600, for partner B, 1,200, and for partner C is an 800. Okay. So after that, because in this problem, we got the loss. So when we are getting any loss, so at working notes, there are three partners are there, A, B, and C. So C is an insolvent. C is an insolvent. Okay, so if at all we are getting any loss, okay, so that the same amount, whatever the loss we got, that you will be going to transfer to the credit side as a bank, by bank except insolvent partner. So for partner A is the same 1,600, for partner B same 1,200, but for partner C we not going to distribute because he is an insolvent. Okay. Now after that, we need to do some working notes. So because C is an insolvent, so debit side we got the amount of 800, then credit side is 500. So 800 minus 500, we are getting 300. So 300 is an deficiency. So this deficiency will be distributed into the capital ratio. Into the capital ratio. Okay. So what is the ratio of capital ratio? So how with the capital we going to find out the ratio. So for example, A, B, C. So for A, the capital is how much? 4000. And for B, it is in 2000. For C, we not going to do because C is an insolvent. So three zeros cancel. So it will be 4:2. So 4:2 means two ones. It will be cancelled. 2 ones are 2 twos are. So the now your ratio is 2:1. Okay. So this 300 you will be going to distribute in the ratio of 2:1. So 300 into 2/3 will get 200. See, 300 into 1/3, 100. Okay. So whoever become the insolvent, again I'll repeat, there are three partners was there, A, B, C. So C become the insolvent. Okay, C become the insolvent. So we have to find out the ratios from the capital. So remaining. So who are the left? That is A and B. So A and B, the capitals are 4000 and 2000. So if we calculate, we got the ratio is 2:1. Okay. Now this 200 and 100, we going to distribute into the partner's capital account as A by A's and B's capital. We'll write it as A's and B, but amount we'll write it on a C, that is a 300. Okay, we got the 300, no? So we'll write it on the C column as a 300. Now debit side, you will write it as a 2 C's capital, but amount you will write it on a partner and B. How much? 200 and 100. Okay, so with this, if we do the total, we'll get for A, it is a total is 5600. So we'll get two balance carried down, that is 1600. Then B side total will get 3200. So 3200 minus 1200 and 100 will get 1900. Then here both the side balance we got equally. So we did not got for the C anything. Okay. So this is the way to do the partner's capital account. After that, the next one is bank account. So in the bank account, the first entry will write it as a 2 balance brought down. So in the balance sheet, you need to check any cash or a bank amount is given or not. So in this problem, they gave how much? 1500. Okay. After that, we need to check first account is realization account. Okay. So in the realization account, do you finding anywhere as a bank? So debit side, we find it as a bank. Right, so you will write it on a credit side by realization account in brackets creditors, how much? 3500. Then after that, credit side, do we finding any bank? Yes, that is land and building. So it is on a credit side. So we'll write it on a debit side to realization account in brackets land and building 2700. Then after that, come to the partner's capital account. So in the partner's capital account, do we finding anywhere as a bank? So debit side, we don't have any bank. In credit side, we are there. In credit side, the amount is there 1600 and 1200. So this it is on a credit side. So we'll write it on a debit side to A's capital, that is 1600. Then to B's capital 1200. Then after that, this carried on amount we'll write it as a bank. So it is on a debit side. So by Ace Capital, that is 1600. By Beast Capital, 1900. So if we do the total, we'll get 7000. Here also 7000. So this is the way to do the insolvency of a partner. Okay, so the first thing is we'll prepare realization account. Balance sheet items of assets you will be writing on the debit side except cash. Then balance sheet liabilities you will write it on a credit side as a current liabilities. Whatever the current liabilities are there, that will write it. Then assets realized, liabilities as well as assets you will be writing on the opposite direction as a bank. Okay, as a bank. Then partners capital account, then bank account. Thank you.